Fixing overexposed skies in Lightroom is a challenge that you'll discover how to fix in this Lightroom tutorial. Plus, I'll share the biggest Lightroom editing mistakes that I see, how to avoid it, and another pro editing tip. So this particular image right here is one that I captured at Letchworth State Park in New York, which is known as the Grand Canyon of the East. And the dynamic range of the scene at the time I captured this, which was just before sunrise, was very large, which makes our jobs as photographers and editors difficult, unless of course your camera is able to capture a wide range of brightness levels. And it also helps to know the secret to whether or not you have details in your overexposed skies before you begin editing. And that secret is your histogram. So let's take a look at, actually not this one, let's take a look at this image here, because the sky is a lot more overexposed than this one over here, and it will show what I'm referring to when learning how to read your histogram a little bit better. So if we take a look at the histogram, we can see there's some peaks and valleys. So those peaks and valleys let you know there's detail in that part of the tonal range. So there's a good chance we can recover some of that detail with our editing tools here in the basic panel. Right now I have nothing except for the highlights here. Let's reset that. So if I adjust my highlights here to the left, that's going to begin recovering the detail, and the clouds are now visible, or a lot more so than they were before. But that's not how I recommend editing your overexposed skies, and I'll explain why in just a second. Let's first take a look at this image here, and we can see that the histogram is different. So we don't have the same amount of peaks and valleys. That's a lot flatter than it was before in the previous image, and we have a big spike here. So chances are we may not be able to recover any detail. So let's see if we can or not. So I'm going to drag the highlight slider to the left, and the detail is not coming back. The clouds are not visible. The further I go, it still doesn't work. And that's because all the detail in that part of the image was clipped at the time of capture. Another thing you can do is you can turn on your clipping mask here, and you can see everything in red means that there's no detail. So if you're seeing this in your overexposed skies, I have some bad news. You're not going to be able to recover that detail because it wasn't captured at the time you took the photo. So the only solution then is to try and capture the detail at the time you're creating the photo. And the thing that you can do is you can look at the histogram after you take the image and see if there's any peaks and valleys in the shadows and the highlights and the whites and the blacks to ensure you're capturing all the details at that time. That way you know you can enhance them later on if you have some detail there. All right, now let me show you why you shouldn't use your highlight slider from the basic panel or the light panel if you're using Lightroom and not Lightroom Classic. For this particular file, I increased the shadows at plus 16 and plus 2, texture and clarity at plus 15. That's the only edits applied so far to this image. And when I start editing my images, I will do these types of tonal adjustments in the basic panel or the light panel if you're using Lightroom before I fix the sky. So this part of the image here below the sky is in a gorge, and the trees and the river here are very dark, which is why I increased the shadows. But look what happens when I adjust my highlight slider. If I go to the left, I bring back the detail in the clouds. But if I continue going further, it's easier to see what is going on, which is it's making the entire image darker. So even though I come down to, let's say, minus 30, 35, something like that, the rest of the image below the sky is now darker. So that means I have to come in and increase the shadows again. But that creates a problem that we have to now deal with that may not have been there before, and that is digital noise. So for this particular image, I shot with an ISO of 400. It's not going to show a lot of noise, but as you increase the shadows, you're introducing more digital noise to your image, which is another editing challenge that you're going to have to overcome. So at plus 16, I may be introducing a little bit of digital noise, but not as much as I would at a higher setting. So what I like to do is I like to target my sky and my edits directly to the sky, by using Lightroom's built-in artificial intelligence by applying a mask. So all you have to do is click on this sky button here, and then Lightroom will automagically select the sky for us, but it's creating another problem for us that I see a lot of photographers make a mistake, and that is relying on Lightroom to make the selection for us. It's not 100% accurate or 100% perfect. So we have to help Lightroom make a selection of our sky in situations where you have the sky peeking through some branches and leaves, or even on the horizon. Sometimes it's not going to make a perfect selection, and the problem is known as ghosting or a halo effect. Now, before I show you that, let's take a look at what happens when we adjust the highlight. It's just affecting the sky, which is what we want, but we have another problem here. As I continue going to the left, I'm not getting the detail in this part of the image, and I'll tell you how to get that in just a moment. So overall, the sky is better. Well, not really, because it's over editing this part of the image and it's flat. The other problem is we are starting to get that halo effect. So if we zoom in here, we can see it on these branches here. If I go all the way to the left, it's easier to see. Actually, it'll be easier to see with the exposure. So I'm going to drop the exposure all the way down to -4 stops. And you can definitely see that halo effect. And this is a huge mistake I see a lot of photographers do, is they will edit their image based on what Lightroom selects, but they don't fix this halo effect. Yes, this is to the extreme, but you can even see it at a lower setting of -1.5. So how do you get rid of it? It's real simple. All you have to do is add to the selection that Lightroom gave you to start with, and then you're going to gradually build up that edit around the leaves and the branches. So I'm going to click add here. I'm going to select my brush. Now, real quick, I have a favor to ask, and that is, if you're enjoying this Lightroom tutorial, please show some love by liking this video. Now, the solution is to adjust these settings over here, because if I begin painting along the edges here to get rid of that halo, look at that. The trees and the branches are now pure black. We don't want that. We want to slowly build it up to gradually apply that edit from the sky into the tree. So we want to feather it in, and we can do that by adjusting the flow. So think of flow like a spray paint can. The harder you hold that button down, the faster that paint is going to come out. So flow at 100 is 100% of the edit is being applied to where you applied those brush strokes. 50 is 50%, so half as much of the edit is being applied. And then 23%. So it's going to take a little time and practice to figure out what settings to use. I like to use around 20 to 30, maybe more or less, depending on the image. So all I'm going to do now is I'm going to click and drag. So I'm clicking on the branches and the leaves, and I'm dragging away, and that's slowly building up. And I want to overlap some of these brush strokes to gradually blend that in. Now up here, we can see those branches are white, has a halo effect. So I don't mind adding a little bit more in this area. Even though those branches are going to be darker, that's okay. For the rest of them, I'm going to slowly click and drag into the tree, along the edge and inside as well, to slowly build it up and apply those edits that I'm going to apply in a second to this area as well. And then you'll get rid of that halo effect. So I would spend a little bit more time on that than what I'm doing right now. You get the idea. There's no need to do it anymore. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust the exposure now, because when I have an overexposed sky, I want to compensate for that by adjusting the exposure. How much depends on the image. So for this particular image, maybe -1 to 1.5 stops. I'm going to go right about there, and I'm going to now try my highlights to see if I can fix it even more. It's bringing back a little bit of detail, but not as much. And it's creating a bigger problem, which is it's creating more of a muddy or neutral or flat type of effect to this part of the image, and it looks unnatural. So sometimes I will never use the highlight slider, but other times I will use it more so than I am now. In fact, I'm not even going to use highlights for this particular image because I don't like the end result. Now, the secret key ingredient for bringing out detail in your sky, colors, definition, depth, detail, is adjusting these tools right here, texture, clarity, and dehaze. So I use these all the time for fixing my sky. So here's the before and after of this one. And by adjusting the texture, clarity, and dehaze, I'm able to bring back that detail and add color. But you want to be careful when you're applying these settings because you can overdo it. Now, as far as texture, it's going to be a lot more subtle. So texture is going to give the appearance that the clouds are getting sharper. And I wouldn't go this high, but it's easier to see that it's sharper the further to the right I go. Now, clarity is going to add more contrast compared to clarity. It'd help if I actually selected the mask here. So texture is going to show more detail and sharpening. Clarity is going to add more contrast. Again, I wouldn't go too far, otherwise it's going to start looking unnatural. And I want my landscapes to look as natural as possible without overdoing it. And it's a personal preference as well. So for clarity, I might go right around plus 25. Now, dehaze is usually used to remove haze or fog or mist in your images, but I like to use it to enhance my skies as well. And it's going to be a little bit more dramatic than the other two settings. It's going to add more depth and more sharpness to the overall sky. Now, we do have a huge problem right here, and that's in this area right here. I wasn't able to recover any detail in that area. So it looks like actually I've over edited this image. I think I need to drop some of these settings down. So the thing is, if the detail isn't there, we can't bring it back no matter how much we try to edit the image. So what we need to do is we need to try and capture that detail in camera with what is known as HDR photography. So here's the end result of merging three different exposures to get that HDR image, which shows the detail in this part of the image that isn't here. How cool is that? So if you want to learn more about HDR photography, let me know in the comments. Now, the question is, how do you fix underexposed images? Because the editing steps to do so are different from overexposed. And to learn how to fix your underexposed images with the secret tools, check out this video tutorial right here.